Okay, everybody. So we are going to go into another example of this plein air drawing. So just like the last one, I want to rough in some elements on the page. This is actually going to operate as kind of a horizontal horizon line, but it feels like more of the a fence line. But I'm going to lock into some elements, some trees that I cluster trees that I thought was interesting with the way that the shadow play operated. So I want to get the rough shape of the trees blocked in. And for this, I really am paying attention to what the trunk looks like, and then also starting to see where the branches fall from the tree. Similar to that first drawing exercise we did with charcoal of the semester, I want us to look at really what's going on with the tree. It's not just a lollipop tree. It doesn't just go straight up with limbs that are symmetrical on both sides. Really pay attention to where the trees are. So here I'm starting to block in a second tree. It's a small grouping of trees. As you can see, very bright on the page. I'm using a marker this time because my last drawing, the pencil didn't show up well, and also it was in a bit of tree shadow, but then as the sun moved, started to change on paper. You can see everything. So I'm going with a marker here. So it's very permanent, but I like working with these thin sharpies. So blocking in these trees, and they're not the same trees. They're actually the same kind of tree, but I want to make sure that as we are putting these things in, it makes sense that they are not the same. I don't want them to be the same. They aren't the same. So one rectangle you see in there, that's a mat, which would be a fence post. Some gauging how height is working within this composition. Figure out how these limbs operate off of these trunks. Trunks of the trees, they actually taper wider. It's like a small bottom of the trunk where it meets the land. So people aren't really sure oftentimes of how the trunks meet the grass. But just drawing what you see, just paying attention to what you're noticing. Observation. Since I know these trunks are going to be really in the shadows and really dark, it doesn't bother me if I'm drawing my lines through them. Board. Boards are black, so it will show up that way on the drawing. This is a very simple drawing. I just want to get a general idea of this activity of trying to draw nature. And oftentimes I try to shy away from man-made objects. There's actually a little run-in structure in the distance that I'm looking at, or that I was looking at. I'm going to leave that out just because I think I really want to identify nature, partially because nature is very forgiving. If you don't get things absolutely clear and right, the tree won't be bothered by it. Whereas if you're drawing a portrait, people really knock holes and things aren't accurate. So now, gauging value within these trees. They are very heavy. Trees, in terms of the shadows that's being cast from their evergreen or fir trees, their cedar, sure, but whatever they are, they're not funded all around, they are cut low. Stretch. So, there's a lot to do, and I often we'll attack things that are very, very dark first, just to get an idea of where things stand. So the trunks are almost black, and the boards are black, so peck away. Okay, back to the way the branches operate and what's hanging on the branches, these little leaves, I guess. They're very spiky. So in my last drawing, they're a lot rounder, but these, not only are the branches more angular, but the leaves, or the furs, or whatever they're called, they're actually a lot spikier, a lot like needles. Because they are so heavy, they will capture, or they will hold a lot of this dark value on. Last drawing. We oftentimes think that if we were to draw a Christmas tree, it looks a certain way, but where we really find accuracy and truth is when we pay attention to observe. Sometimes the needles will be pointing up, sometimes they'll be flat, sometimes they'll be sagging down, depending upon how much weight is on branches. Unfortunately, in this drawing, there's not a whole lot of highlights happening because I'm a little lower on the trees. Like, towards the top of the trees, they might end up having some more highlights, and I wouldn't have to bear down as much with the laying over lots and lots of these needle lines. I don't know if you can tell this enough, but too much scraggly beard growing in. But I'm picking my head up every couple seconds just to make sure that I'm getting the right quality. So I'm spending about as much time drawing as I am observing. Oftentimes, because I do really feel that the activity of this blind counter drawing, that very first activity we did, it makes a lot of sense, and you're able to even look away for a brief second and keep that idea of what you want to have happen in front of you as long as you check back in after your drawing. They were right on. I'm constantly looking up, looking up, looking up. Okay. I'm going to sped up the speed so that we can cover the ground. Filler talk. Okay, so working on some shadows now, and as I mentioned before, shadows on these trees will often run very horizontal. The shadows that get towards the end that might have an indication of grass. The shadow is cast on some of these right near the fence posts. It was catching the light in such a way that it was creating a shadow there. I start to get further and further down this drawing. I'm really recognizing why I want more and more value to occur. And overall, I think this drawing took me about 30 minutes. That's about as much time as I want you to spend, unless you're really enjoying the activity and you're getting lost in it. You can absolutely spend more time if you like. You spend about 30 minutes shots. transition, as I mentioned in my last drawing activity, it's a good idea to consider the whole rectangle piece of paper. How do you fill out a frame in such a way that it makes it seem as though it's not forgotten? Unless you want to have a little bit of this compression of activity with a release of not a whole lot of marketing. If there were a similar amount of marks and darkness all over the page, then it might feel a little boring. So I was really hoping to lead the viewer over towards this right side and push them up towards the top right. I'm just trying to give a little indication of some foliage behind it. I don't go too deep in the detail. As I mentioned in the previous exercise, you are welcome to draw things further off than it is more simply. That's how perspective works. The further away something gets, the less we can see it. So this is what I was looking at, these trees right here in the yard. And this was my final drawing. So as we move through, you can see that it's really a lot of scribbles, but the manner in which I've placed the scribbles hopefully gives you an idea of what the space looks like. So you don't have to work in pen, although some people do enjoy working with pen. You can do that, or you can continue on pencil. You probably won't find that you need to use the eraser too much, and that just might slow you down unless you want to draw with the eraser to create highlights or things like that, and that's totally up to you. But I don't think that I would have used an eraser had I had the opportunity to have an eraser. I was using pencil. So good luck, and I look forward to seeing your results.